Hey everybody, it's Big Daddy Taz. I wish I could be there in person again to raise funds and awareness, of course, for the mental health initiatives of the North. I had so much fun when I was there. I felt like I was at home. I felt like a part of a big family up there, and it was really, really nice to share the stage with everybody and all the local comedians and everybody else too. COVID has made it not possible for us to do many things. And including laughing. I don't know what COVID's been like for you, but for me, it's been a real struggle. For many entertainers, actually, a real struggle. But for me personally, I can tell you, it's the most depressed I've been in 15 years. You know, it's not being able to get on stage and make people laugh and not earn a living and wondering where, you know, finances are going to come from or what's next and things like that. And I just let it, you know, weigh me down until it pushed me into a dark hole. And I'm the type of guy that won't reach out and ask for help, even though I know that that's one of the big answers is to ask for help, right? But a lot of people were calling me for advice, and I was giving them advice, but then it would be done giving them advice. I wouldn't take that same advice for myself. And that's just that every day is just a new day, right? It's just was very hard for me, and I'm glad to say I'm out of my depression now. And I think part of it was not being able to make people laugh. Making people laugh is my medication, and I love it very much. And the one thing that I have been doing, I replaced it with going on Facebook Live and reading to kids, and it's been very much fun. I thought I was going to get a lot more done. I thought I was going to get a lot more done for COVID. You know, I had all these big plans of getting. I'm going to get that done. I'm going to write this book. I'm going to do this. Nah, I grew this beard. That's the only thing that I did. It's pretty awesome beard, but also, ironically, I grew the beard by being lazy and not wanting to shave. What to do? The organizers had asked me to, you know, do a 5 or 7 little minute video for you, but I didn't want to do one just to the camera. So instead, I picked one of my favorite appearances at the Winnipeg Comedy Festival to share with you, and it's about my struggles with mental health and things. And I think it's apropos, and I hope you enjoy it. We're going to show that in a couple minutes. So, yeah. The biggest advice I want to give you is that reach out. Reach out if you're feeling sad. Reach out if reach out to your forever people when you're anxious and things like that. Reach out and don't be embarrassed to reach out. For some reason, this time I didn't want to reach out and ask for help. And finally, I did. And I reached out to my psychiatrist, and I reached out to my friends, and I reached out to my colleagues and my family, and just told them how much I was struggling. And it came to us as a surprise to many of them, because I'm always cheery, happy on the outside for the most part. And then I started sharing on Facebook the struggles that I was going through as well. And I got a couple of emails saying that me sharing helped those people get through what they needed, and they weren't afraid to ask for help. It's weird to me to know what I know about mental health and know what I know about my own mental health and not being able to heal myself. But I'm on the mend, and I'm happy. I'm happier now than I have been in the last 6 months. I really wish I could be there to bring the laughter, to feel your laughter, to have the camaraderie and things. And I sure miss handshakes and hugs and things like that. I'm sure they're coming again. But take good care of yourself, not only physically, of course, by social distancing and whatever else you need to do, wearing a mask and things like that. But take care of your mental health as well. Right? That's going to be key to getting through this. Laugh as much as you can. Find the joy in every moment that you can. And I am sort of tired of people saying, oh, everything happens for a reason. I kind of want to kick them in the nuts and go, hey, you know why that happened? But I won't, because I'm not supposed to. But enjoy this clip that I have. And if you need to, please reach out. And the initiatives that we're raising money for in the North here for the mental health initiatives are so very important. So thank you for letting me be part of this. And thank you so much for letting me make you laugh. It's so very important. And I'm kind of a goof because I laugh at my own stuff. So, and I know that I've been home quite a bit, when my son always asked me the other day, Dad, you know, you always wear these shirts untucked. How come you wear your shirts untucked? I said, it's to hide my big belly. He goes, it's not a magic shirt, Dad. There's always family to help me be humble and to help me write material. Lots of love from my family to yours, and I hope to see you soon. so much sooner than later, that's for sure. Take care of yourself. It's what's very important.